So what I'd like to talk about now is a little bit more detail on some of the different ways that we have to generate random inputs to our software under test. So let's start off with our diagram showing the random test case generator. And if you recall from the diagram a little bit earlier in this unit, this test case generator has two inputs. It takes pseudo-random numbers from a pseudo-random number generator, and it's also predicated on some amount of knowledge of the input domain, and that's supplied by a human. Now, we already looked at one example, testing the adder, where essentially no domain knowledge was needed. That is to say, the random test case generator pretty much took its pseudo-random numbers and use them directly as test cases. We looked at a different example, that is to say, the credit card number generator, where pseudo-random numbers part of the input, and they weren't directly parroted to the output, but rather they parameterized an algorithm which created valid credit card numbers. And of course, it's possible to carry that kind of logic farther, as in the example of where we're testing a file system and we need to generate valid sequences of API calls. We're testing a web browser where we need to actually generate well-formed HTML in order to test certain parts of the browser. But it turns out all of these ways of generating input are variations on a single theme, which we call generative random testing. And generative random testing simply means that inputs are created from scratch. And there's an entirely different approach called mutation-based random testing. Inputs are created by randomly modifying existing non-randomly created inputs to the software under test. And so what that does is changes our diagram a little bit so that we have a separate source of input, which is the existing test case. One thing we might ask ourselves is, well, which approach is better? As far as I know, there's no cut and dried answer to that. Sometimes generative works really well, sometimes mutation-based testing works really well, and it really just depends on the situation and how much time you have to spend. In general, my view is that generative testing might be a little bit better at ferreting out really weird errors, but it's a lot more work to create entire random tests, at least if there are sophisticated constraints on their form, from scratch. Mutation testing, on the other hand, has a different strength. So let's take a look at that.